This is going to be it out. All right, let's see who he picks up. Hi.
Hey, Denise, how you doing?
How are you? Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you. It's my pleasure.
Ooh, I like your Oakleys. Should I wear my Oakleys too? Wear my Oakleys. I feel like I should wear
them. Yeah, why not? Why not?
Aquí no hay sol.
Aquí sí, aquí apenas son las 4 de la tarde.
Damn, but yours are better than mine. Look at this.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
Fine.
So, you're in Texas right now, right?
Nah, Arizona.
Arizona? Ooh, is it hot over there?
It's pretty hot. It's like 90 today.
Pues tú estás bien para allá. Y yo en este frío.
Dale para acá, mira que tenemos todo, mira. Una vaina bacana.
A la piscina. Damn, I don't got anything behind me, just my room. So tell us about yourself. Like, why are you in Arizona? Where are you from?
Well, I was born in the Dominican Republic, and
¿tú puedes hablar español también si quieres?
Bueno, yo nací en Dominicana, en Santo Domingo. Luego me mudé para acá, para Nueva York, en Freeport, Long Island. So jugué allá en college, en ASA College, que está ahí entre, hay dos campus, en Manhattan y en Brooklyn. So I went to JUCO, and then fui para una escuela de 4 años, y aquí estoy ahora. Estoy en Arizona ahora mismo, pero que es porque soy con mi familia. Pero la universidad que estoy yendo es ahí en Texas, en Plainview.
En Texas. Bueno, es mejor que estar en una universidad de aquí, que no hay calor. Only once a year.
Ya lo sabes.
Well, you live in Long Island. You live near me. I live in Queens.
Oh, yeah. That's like 20 minutes.
I live right there. I play softball, too, but I wasn't good.
Oh, my God.
I was okay. My hitting was good. My throwing was, all over the place. Because I used to be a pitcher before.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. But anyways, how are you doing, you know, with this epidemic? Like, what are you doing, like, to keep yourself busy?
I mean, right now I'm just like going hiking with my sister and my brother-in-law and, you know, just trying to stay in shape, you know, doing something, staying productive because, you know, you gotta do something, you know.
No hay nada que hacer.
No hay nada que hacer. So I just go running, I just go hiking, I just go, you know, I got a net, baseball net in my backyard. So I keep like throwing, you know.
Yeah. ¿Tú tienes un entrenador para allá o solamente tú lo haces solo?
Ahora mismo estoy solo, ahora mismo, porque tú sabes, la gente tiene miedo de salir, tú sabes, para no infectarse.
Sí.
So, yo me mantengo solo, me mantengo haciendo mi conditioning, always, you know, tratando de encontrar la forma de hacer el trabajo.
You're not scared to be out there by yourself?
Nah. Nah.
So, from my bosses from HCP, they saw a video of you throwing into a net in your backyard. Is that the only thing that you're doing to stay productive, or are you doing running?
Yeah, running, hiking. Yeah, running, hiking, doing a lot, you know.
But you know, none of that matters if you're not eating right. ¿Está comiendo bien?
Claro que estoy comiendo bien.
Porque se va a notar. En 1, 2, 3 meses.
No, no, mira, yo estoy bien. Mira, no hay barriga ni nada.
Espérate, se me olvidó los lentes. I don't even think I can see with my shades, with my Oakleys. I gotta wear Oakleys, people, because he's wearing Oakleys. But anyway, how was your experience, you know, playing in Texas? Did you like it?
I loved it. I loved my team. You know, Wayland Baptist University had the best coaching, the best teammates. The bags, it was like such a nice experience for me, you know, because I got to play with a few Dominicans.
Espérate, oye, que yo estoy nada con estos lentes. I can't see nothing with those. I can't see people's comments, but carry on, sorry.
So, yeah, jugando allá en Wayland fue una experiencia bien maravillosa para mí. I know when those coaches, my teammates, they're great. Y lo único que no me gustó fue la brisa. Hay mucha brisa, mucha brisa.
Te llevo la brisa con todo.
Sí, you know, it's challenging. It's challenging because you got to keep the board low.
Sí. Yeah.
Because si tú tiras alto, cualquier palo se va.
Yo estoy aprendiendo contigo. I'm learning with you because I didn't know that.
Ya lo sabes.
So, software grande y si tú la tiras cae, como quiera.
Ya lo sabes.
That's crazy. We saw that you had a no-hitter going into the last inning. Well, these are questions que tuve. La gente quieren saber de ti. What was your game plan going in and how did it feel?
Yeah.
Hay que verte jugando.
Ay, tiene que darle para acá, tiene que darle para acá. So, la verdad.
But you know what's crazy? I've seen a lot of MLB players that say that when they threw a no-hitter, they were so focused. Estaban tan enfocados que ni se dieron cuenta. Eso fue tu
tole. Exactamente. Exactamente.
Was that you?
Exactamente. That was me that day. Eso fue, creo que fue marzo 17, por ahí, más o menos. Ese fue el último día de la temporada. Se estaba rumorando que no iba a haber más temporada por el coronavirus. Mm-hmm. Because of the coronavirus, that was supposed to be our last game. So I was like, oh my God, I was going crazy. And I just wanted to give myself like 110% that day, you know? And just like, you know, putting everything into work. And lo que yo quería hacer era poner los bateadores a batear. Si ellos podían darle, que le den. O sea, yo estaba confiando en mi defensa, en mi equipo. Y la adrenalina del juego me llevó, tú sabes, a hacer un gran trabajo ese día.
Y tú sabes que algunos pitchers se le olvida que tienen equipo. Tienen tantas cosas que no lo ponen en su equipo. Like, a lot of pitchers forget that they have teammates and it's okay if a player hits your ball, you got teammates in the back to support you. But, LJ, you won pitcher of the week? Twice?
Yeah, twice. Twice this season.
Bueno, pero estoy hablando con un pelotero en la MLB, okay. What was that working for you? Like, how did you feel? How did your parents feel?
They're very proud of me. I gotta say that, you know, they're very happy for me, you know, and ellos me han dado mucho apoyo durante la temporada, y tú sabes, las oraciones, y claro. Eso, tú sabes, todo eso llega, y, you know, thank God for everything, you know, but that weekend's player, pitcher of the weekend, that was amazing for me, you know, that was my first time winning that, and...
Pero dos veces.
Dos veces, twice.
We're going for it. It's okay. No, pero...
Yeah, just,
if you hear the background, I think I hear my mom praying in the back. She has not stopped praying at all. So it's funny
that hurt.
Cantando y todo eso. Are you excited about the draft?
Oh, yeah. A lot. Very excited. You know, and because I have a few, like, teammates that they can get drafted just like me, you know. Luis Vargas.
You want to get drafted together?
Yeah, we can. I mean, I'm so excited, but I'm not selfish about it. You know that I can, like, you know, say that my two of my teammates, you know, they can get drafted as well with me. So Gregory Osuna, Luis Vargas, they did a great job this season, and you know that possibility that we can go together and keep playing together, you know. That keeps me, like, happy, you know.
That's awesome. You have that mentality. You sound very humble, too. And it's important to have that. Like, a lot of people, like, when they get to where you are, they forget to be humble and they forget, you know, to not be selfish with those around you. Because if you're good, you're good. But when you have those who are good around you, it affects you even more, you know?
Yeah.
100%. So that's very important. What tips would you give, you know, younger pitchers and stuff, especially now, like, what they could be doing, what they like, how their mentality should be right now?
I mean, I think there's no excuse, you know. Sometimes we get, like, confused about, like, saying, oh, I got no time for this. Now we got time, you know, to do everything we want. So get some running, get some bands. If you can go to the gym, do something at your house, you know, at your place. that, you know, push-ups, whatever, you know, to stay in shape, to get stronger. So whenever we get out, whenever we get out of this situation, we get better, not the same or, you know, worse. You know what I mean?
I have a question, because now I'm really curious. Your favorite pitch, and what's the hardest that you could throw? Because I heard you throw about 98 miles per hour. And you don't have to be so humble about this. You can tell us. Because either way, if we go and watch, you
play. I mean, I've been working really hard, you know, in the off season, and yeah, I mean,
uno de tu amigo dijo 102.
Yeah, but that was with the shuffle, like with the momentum. I mean, from the outfield.
Wait. You threw 100. You no. And you're acting so humble about it. You know that's big, right? Heard Chapman.
I try always, you know, to keep it, you know, to keep my feet on the ground, you know.
Where can we, after this is over, where can we go watch you play?
We have hopefully to go in the pros.
Somebody wrote, I wrote something down, and somebody told me that you're expected in the first 10 rounds in this year's draft, but the HCP thinks that you should go in the first 3. Do you know, like, where you'll be? Like, are you going to be in Texas when you get this call, or are you planning on going back to, you know, Long Island?
I'm going to be here in Phoenix. Yeah. So whatever happens, you know, there's a lot of teams. I mean, the Seattle Mariners, they were, like, watching every game. Mm-hmm. They were, like, I mean, every one of my games, they were, like, watching me with the red gun and, you know, recording me. So, and they play over here in Phoenix. Also, the Oakland Athletics, they play over here. And the Cubs, the Cincinnati Reds. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so I think whatever happens, I'm going to stay here, you know.
Phoenix. Do you, like, let's say the Yankees or the Mets sign you. Are you going to be just as excited? Because technically you live in Long Island. You can go home whenever.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you know. I grew up being a Yankee fan, and, you know, I love the Yankees, but I can go with whoever, you know.
I work for the
I just want my opportunity to go pro. Doesn't matter with who, you know. I just want to showcase my talent and, you know.
Bueno, wishes to you. Pero before I let you go, I heard that you play the guira, and the people and I want to see you play it.
The guira? No, I play the saxophone.
But we want to see you play it.
Oh, so you my God.
You know what, LJ? You have to give us, you have to give me and the people some motivation. Look, I'll even wear my glasses again. We want to hear something, you know?
Let me see if I can.
Oh, it's getting spicy, guys. He's going to play something
for us. Let me get this thing.
Let me read the comments. Let me have it. Este amigo tú, Murphy. Así que se llama tu amigo.
Murphy, uh-huh.
Murphy is your number one fan.
That's my brother. You know, he throws 100 from the mound.
¿Y fuiste tú que lo enseñaste?
No, no, los dos trabajamos juntos, tú sabes.
That's cool that he's over here supporting you.
Yeah, that's my boy.
Oh,
that's my
boy.
Let me see if I can remember.
Here,
so
she could dance.
Let me see. Let me play.
I put it.
You know, Titanic. You know, Titanic.
Yes, I love Titanic. I wish I could sing. I could sing, and then you could play in the back. But never mind.
Okay, let me see if I can play that one for you.
Let me get my tissues. I'm ready. Go ahead. Guys, estamos. Murphy, busca tu tibieta.
Murphy.
little tears because I got my mascara. I would cry. You're so good.
Thank you.
Y tú sabes que I know a lot of typical bands and a lot of bands that will hire you like that.
Oh yeah. Let me know. Let me know.
Look at these comments. You have like a fan club over here. A sí mismo. That's so great. You're so good. Eljo, we have to definitely go see you play. And if you want to come visit me at work, even though by then you'll be fine. But I'm hosting the Yankees this summer in Staten Island.
Mm-hmm.
So if you ever want to come to a game, let me know. Well, hopefully I get to see you playing on the field, though.
That'll be lit.
Oh, my God. I'm so excited that we got to hear you play. I feel special. Here at HCP, I think, like, we're going to feel special. Like, I'm going to brag about this if I ever see you on the field. I'm going to be like, yeah, I interviewed him, and he got to play.
You know what? I need my shirt.
You need your shirt. Let me write this down. What size are you? No, I'm going to definitely talk to Elvis so he could send you a shirt. Mira, si quieres la mía, te mando la mía también.
Mándala.
I don't think you fit into a medium. But... LJ, good luck to you in this draft. Thank you so much. I actually had a lot of fun with you here on live.
It was my pleasure.
Actually my first person on the HCP that I go on live with, so it was pretty fun. And thank you so much for playing for us. We're going to send you that shirt, but thank you for being on live with us.
Enjoy the night.
And thank you to everybody that tuned in and your fan club, Melfi's, your number one fan. Hope you and your family stay safe.
Thank you. God bless you.
You too. Bye, LJ.
Bye-bye.
You guys, how crazy was that? Like, this guy killed it. He killed it. I had to wear my Oakleys for him and stuff. But fan número cero. Fan número uno, Murphy. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in. If you have, like, any other players that you want, you know, to know more about and to get on HTP, you know, hit me up at Denisse.ny or hit up HTP2. You know, we'll try to get them on live and get information, you know, and just interview them. And you guys can ask them, you know, what you want to know about them. But don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channels where you can see me being a silly girl on the videos. But everybody be safe and have a good night.